Something more tangible now, however. How did loo paper help to win the Cold War?
Was there a shortage of loo paper in the eastern part of the world? And they...
There was a shortage of loo paper behind the Iron Curtain.
The loo paper was made in America, let's say, and then they didn't let the Russians have any, so they were confused.
That would have been clever, but what happened is the Russians instead used documents and all kinds of things for loo paper, because there was nothing else to use. And an operation called Operation Tamarisk meant that the spies behind the Iron Curtain had to go into these bins and find the paper that had been used, because it wasn't soluble like lavatory paper, so it couldn't be used in the sewage system, so it was just thrown out in bins.
Gone right off spying now.
Yeah, I think it was quite glamorous.
It's not all glamour, I'm afraid, because in military hospitals, the paper refuse that they went through also contained amputated limbs. And the spies were complaining to their handlers back in America and the UK and France and said, you know, this is horrible, we've got to go through these bins and there's these amputated limbs, we've got to go through those as well as used lavatory paper. And of course their spymaster said, oh, bring back the limbs as well, we want to see what sort of shrapnel they're using. So they had to carry around severed limbs and excreted matter.
So if they stopped going through customs, could you just open the bag?
It's a bit of a shock.
Yes.
Even for a customs officer who's seen everything.
For personal use.
But apparently, according to The Hidden Hand by Richard Aldridge, a book that covers this, it says that Operation Tamarisk was very successful. It, maybe without it, we'd still have communist Russia, who knows?